because of the men and women who served our nation somewhere in the military. These people who are standing made it possible for us to be free to do what we're doing this morning. Don't ever forget. We have a volunteer military now, but most of these men who are standing didn't have that choice. They were drafted. It's different now. I don't know how many of you, if any of you, came up and looked at the table here this morning. We've done this some, what, Ed, 4 years now, seems like. So I'm going to read this thing about what this represents. And I would ask you after the service sometime, come up and just look and take a moment and be grateful for the freedom we have. There's a small table here with a white cloth on it to honor a soldier's pure heart when he answers the company's call to duty. On the plate on the table, there's a lemon slice and some grains of salt to show a captive soldier's faith and tears of families waiting for loved ones to return. There's an empty chair at the table for the missing soldiers who are not here, or maybe I should say the missing military. Some gave all. There's a black napkin for the sorrow of captivity and a glass that is turned over for a meal that won't be eaten. There's a white candle for peace, and finally a red rose in a vase tied with a red ribbon for the hope that all our missing will return someday. We should not forget, so long as there's one left in whom memory remains. There's a yellow ribbon vowing never will we forget. I guess the older you get, the more these things mean. But I would challenge our parents and grandparents, make sure the kids know it. Would you join me for a word of prayer? Father, I'm honored to stand in the presence of those who have served our nation. And I would speak a blessing to each one of them. I know those of us here who stand didn't have to pay the ultimate price, but many did. And I pray, Lord, that these tokens of things that many do not understand push our memory to recall. I pray your blessings upon this nation, upon our president, the Congress, and all those who serve in various capacities. Keep a watch over our military, Lord. Keep them strong in their faith and in the natural so that they can serve you. Keep us free. And I speak it all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's give them a hand one more time. Hallelujah. Thank you again. Ushers, would you come, please? Sitting at the house yesterday morning, and and I got a bowl of cereal. I don't normally eat cereal. I love cereal, but I hadn't eaten cereal in a while. I'm sitting there eating cereal, and I had my Bible laid out, and I started to just go over my notes and stuff that I'm going to be preaching, or I thought I was going to be preaching. Anyway, that's another story. But I was just thinking how blessed we are. You know, I go to different countries. I've been to Africa, I've been to Dominican Republic, Haiti, Honduras, and we're so blessed. And the only reason that that's the case is because of men and women and what you've done to serve our country. And I mean, I really appreciate it. I feel like we all probably take it for granted. And but this weekend, I really thought a lot about you guys, and I really appreciate everything that you've done. Let's pray. Father, we love you, and we give you praise for the freedom that we do have in America. I realize, Lord, that there's many that's home, laying in the bed, and when they could be at the house of God thanking you for our freedom, but Lord, they're still free where they're at. And God, this country's in a mess right now, and we need revival. We need a move of God desperately. And Lord, I pray in Jesus' name that whatever it takes to shake America at its core, that you would allow it to happen so that we'll return to you. Lord, this is a great nation, one nation under God. But Lord, we're not living like that. And so I pray for all the sacrifices that these men and women have made throughout the years. They didn't make them for this country to turn out being like it is right now. Cause unity to come forth, Lord. Cause the enemy to be scattered in Jesus' name. And let your will be done in the USA, Lord, the greatest country, Lord, ever has been. Lord, please do a work in this country. Again, thank you for those that have served. But Lord, thank you for Jesus Christ, who also served, who also gave his life for every single one of us, so we can spend eternity with you in heaven. Lord, I pray over the prayer list. I pray for Peyton Leatherman. I pray for Kirsten, that you minister to her and her baby. And God, I pray for all those that have been in the hospital, those that have been sick, those that's going through stuff right now. I pray in Jesus' name that you would heal them, Lord. Lord, I thank you for our visitors today. I pray that you'd minister to them and bless them. And God, if this is the place that you'd plant them, praise God, we just pray that you'd do that. But if it's somewhere else, then I pray that you'd plant them, Lord, and let them bloom and use the gifts and abilities and talents that you've given them. Move today, Lord. Move through the worship and move through the message. We just praise you for blessing this offering. Help us use this offering to build your kingdom. We give you praise for it. In the precious name of Jesus, we all pray. And everybody said, amen. God bless you.
expect you to do great things in this service. We give you all the glory because you're so worthy. In Jesus' name.
There is an ocean deeper than fear. The tide is rising. There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing from the heart of God. The flood of heaven crashing over us. The tide is rising. We feel it now, bursting up from the ground. We feel it now, we come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river.
Stories of what they think you like, but I've heard tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. And I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide. What we need before we say you.
Who you are.
Just breathe in, breathe in. It's His breath. He gives us life. If you're taking breaths and you're not giving Him praise for those, we're breathing and we don't deserve it. Let's give Him praise this morning. All the earth. Come on, church, let's worship Him like there's no other God, because there is no other God. Our praise this morning. Oh, He's worthy. He's so worthy, God. All the earth will shout Your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing. Yeah.
talked about how it's a privilege to worship the Lord. Talked about the sacrifice that those made to give us opportunity to worship the Lord. And I just encourage you to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. As I sit down here, I'm no different than anybody else. I've got all this stuff that goes on. Every single time we're in worship, the enemy comes in and tries to distract me. I don't know if you're the same way, but he comes in and tries to distract. And I press in, and I press in, and I press in, and I tell the Lord, Lord, I don't know what in the world's going on, but I worship you anyway. I command my flesh to worship you anyway. I speak to those dry bones that's trying to shut me down, and I speak life into those things. And Lord, you know that I was praying, and I worship you, Lord. And I pray that others will press in and not let the enemy hold them down from worshiping the one true God. What a privilege it is to be able to come in here and worship you, Lord. You're awesome. So we do. We speak life to this congregation, Lord. Speak life, Lord, not death. We will worship you, Lord. I sense worshipers in the house. We need to worship, man. It's a privilege. It's an honor to worship the Lord. So I speak that over you. I know the Lord has shared, spoke to others, and they've come and talked to me about just that we would speak life into these dry bones. Speak life, because we all get dry. The enemy tries to come in and he tries to wear us out. But God, we speak life today and not death. We speak life and not death. Thank you for moving by your Spirit. Thank you for doing what you wanted to do. Thank you for confirmation, for speaking to me, Lord, and sharing confirmation, the direction the service should go. We love you, we praise you, and we honor you because you're the only one that can give life. And we thank you for giving life, Lord, in Jesus' precious name. And everybody said, amen. Hallelujah. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah.